Amen. Greetings one and all in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our soon coming King. Praise God if you are tuning at this time. Bless God if you are tuning to a Spring Life service coming to you from the power of faith, deliverance ministry, headquarters located at Free Mercury Place, Mayhem in Clarendon, Jamaica. God bless you, praise God, the original Pastor Bishop Jeff Wilson. Thank God for this another opportunity that we can come to you, amen, with a word from the Lord, a word of encouragement, a word of challenge, a word of strength, a word of courage, hallelujah, a word of healing, a word of miracle, hallelujah. And praise God, today is being, amen, celebrated worldwide as Mother's Day. Praise God. Thank God for all the mothers. So let me wish you all, dear mothers, amen, a happy and blessed Mother's Day. God bless you all. I want to make special mention of the mothers of Zion, amen, who are praying as we go through this difficult time. Amen. In the world, it's not just our country, but the world, we are going through a difficult time. The coronavirus pestilence is wreaking havoc among us. Amen. But those who are praying, prayer warriors and prayer mothers, you are going to let them know you are doing a wonderful work. Amen. Let me encourage you, don't stop praying now, but prayer changes things. And prayer changes you, prayer changes us. Not for the worse, but for the good. Amen. I extend love, blessings to all other mothers, young mothers, middle-aged mothers, elderly mothers. Amen. Christian mothers, non-Christian mothers. Amen. I want to wish you a blessed, amen, Mother's Day. My prayers are with you as you, amen, tune in today. Amen. Without mothers, guess what? There would be no children. Amen. Hallelujah. So we love you all and wish you a blessed day. Amen. Some of you haven't spoken to your mothers in a while. Call her up. Tell her happy Mother's Day. Amen. Yes, regardless of what happened, she's your mother. Amen. Praise God. Things might not be as we would like it to be at the place, praise God, where we wanted to be, as how we would have, amen, praise God, hallelujah, celebrated. But bless God, we can celebrate, amen, way by way of a call, a prayer, a word of encouragement, a word of, I love you, mommy, and I'm sure it will make a difference. Hallelujah. God bless you today. Turn with me, if you have got your Bibles, amen, to the book of, amen, 1 Samuel, and the chapter, amen, chapter 2. I'm going to read 2 verses there, and then I turn over to Proverbs chapter 13, and I'm going to read 2 verses there. Praise God. So the book of 1 Samuel and chapter 2 reads like this. And Hannah prayed and said, my heart rejoices in the Lord, my horn is exalted in the Lord. My mouth is enlarged over my enemies because I rejoice in thy salvation. There is none holy as the Lord, for there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock as our rock. Hallelujah. Proverbs 31, and I read, bless the Lord, verse 1 and 2. The words of King Lemuel, the prophecy that his mother taught him. What, my son? and what the son of my womb, and what the son of my bowels. This is the word of the Lord. Somebody bless the name of Jesus. And today, I'm going to share with you, hallelujah, three wonderful or richest Christian mothers. Three wonderful, or in other words, interested Christian mothers. Two we read about in the Bible as we read a while ago, and of course the other you will hear about as we, amen, bring this into you today. Hallelujah. Now it's very important, praise God, for us to continue in prayer. And we know without a shadow of a doubt, those of you that know to pray know that we can pray to God, and God hears and answers prayer. God promised to give us the desires of our heart and answer the petitions that we made to Him, because He is God. Oh, hallelujah. And today being Mother's Day, as we celebrate worldwide, amen, we thank God for all the mothers, but especially Christian mothers today. Hallelujah. And I read interestingly in the Word of God as I studied, amen, a prayer by a special mother. Amen. Two mothers. And another mother that will bring to your attention later on. Hallelujah. And the first mother, amen, I want to bring to your attention is a mother called Anna. The Bible teaches us Anna was married, hallelujah, to a man called Elkanah. And importantly, my subject is your wonderful, interesting example of what a good mother should be. I say that again, that's what I've been focusing on. Your wonderful, interesting example of what a good mother should be. I hope you can say amen up there. And as I said, was married to a man of God by the name of Elkanah. But it so happens that Hannah would not produce a child. And of course, they wanted to produce children, but no children would come. Oh, hallelujah. But the Bible said this woman of God called Hannah, she went up to the temple and she started to pray to God and pray to God and ask God to bless her. Hallelujah. Praise God with a child. Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. And as she prayed to God, the prophet, amen, at the time, was in the temple, amen, Eli. And he saw Hannah praying, hallelujah, and thought something was wrong with her. Hallelujah, because she was praying, but no words was coming out. For she was travailing before God. Hallelujah, at times, praise God, we want to get, amen, home to God, we battle, have some travailing prayer when we need answers. And Hannah travailed before God in prayer and asked God to bless her with a child. Amen, and God heard the prayer of Hannah. Time will not afford me to give you all the story. Oh, glory to God. But God heard Hannah's prayer. And the Bible said in verse 19 of 1 Samuel chapter 1, and they rose up in the morning early and worshipped before the Lord Hallelujah, this woman of God, a wonderful example of what a mother should be. Amen. She got up and worshiped and returned to their house after coming from Ramah. And the Bible said, Elkanah and knew Hannah and his wife. Hallelujah. And the Lord remembered her. That means the Lord take note that she had prayed and asked God for a child. Oh, the God that we serve, when the doctors say no, God will say yes. God remembered her. When the Bible said in verse 20, wherefore it came to pass, when the time was come about after Hannah had conceived, that she bare a son and called his name Samuel, saying, because, hallelujah, I, amen, have asked him of the Lord. Guess what? You hear that? I have asked him of the Lord. Can you say amen? I prayed to God for him, and God gave him. Hallelujah. And the man in Kenya praised God, and all his house went up to offer unto the Lord here his sacrifice. Amen. And his bow. But Hannah went not up, for she said unto her husband, I will not go up until the child be, amen, not be weaned, and then I will go, amen, bring him that he may appear before the Lord and bear abode forever. And then Elkanah and her husband said unto her, to what seemeth, amen, praise God, be good, tarry until he is weaned. Oh, praise the name of Jesus. Because you see, this mother knew that this son, she prayed for him, she travailed for him, and then she had a plan in mind. Talk to me, somebody. Mothers should have plans for their children. Mothers should consider their children. You don't just bring a child into the world and just leave them like that, let them do and grow up as who they want to be. Hallelujah. You must have a plan for your child. Somebody praise the Lord. The Bible said when Hannah had weaned him, hallelujah, amen, she decided to go up to the man of God. Hallelujah. The Bible said she, amen, and she, verse 26, and she said, oh my Lord, as thy soul liveth, my Lord, amen, he had asked her what to come for at this time. She said, listen, I am the woman that stood by thee here praying unto thee for this child I pray. Oh, hallelujah. For who? For this child I pray. You may be out there and you are not yet a mother, but you are married. You can pray to God and ask him to open that womb to bless you with that child. Are you hearing me, somebody? You may have one already and you want to have another, and you're trying and nothing can happen, but you can pray. You may have a miscarriage, hallelujah, but you can pray and say, God, this time around, let the boy come, let the child come. Somebody praise the Lord. For this child of Palestine, I pray, hallelujah, and the Lord hath given me my petition, which I ask of him. Therefore also I have lent him to the Lord, and as long as he liveth, he shall be lent to the Lord. And hallelujah, he worshiped the Lord there. Can somebody say, worship the Lord? Hannah knew that God gave this child, and he's not going to just come like any other child and do as he pleased to do. Hallelujah, go out in the world and allow him to do whatever he wants to do. And I praise God, decided, I'm lending him to the Lord, that God can use him, that God can bless him and make him a blessing. Somebody praise God. And the Bible said in chapter 2 and verse 1, and I prayed and said, my heart rejoiced. Can you say amen? When you see what God has done, what prayer brings, my heart rejoices in the Lord. My heart is exalted in the Lord. My mouth is enlarged over my enemies because I rejoice in thy salvation. When God do something for you, to prayer, something that has seemed impossible, oh glory to God, then your heart must rejoice in God. And said, God, there is none holy as the Lord, for there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our rock, like our God. Ah, this passage, this text, this chapter is known as Psalm of Hannah. So Hannah, hallelujah, went to the Lord, hallelujah, giving a salutation, honoring God for what the Lord has done. And praise God, you may or may not know the story. Hallelujah, Hannah gave him, hallelujah, to lend him to the Lord. And asked Eli to let him stay in the temple with her and worship and learn the things of God. Oh yes, we may have ambitions. Oh hallelujah, to let God, amen, let our child be, amen, a professional, a doctor, a nurse, a politician, oh, some big person, some person renowned, a leader, amen, nothing is wrong with that, but amen, the first thing that you should do, God, let God take control of your child's life. I guarantee you, God is going to make something beautiful of his life. Oh, praise his wonderful name. Remember my subject, you're a wonderful, interesting example of what a good man should be. Can you say amen? And you're going to wait for the result. So I'm going to pray. And you know this story. God visited Samuel as he's a fool with Eli. God talked to him. And he thought at first when God called him, he thought it was Eli calling. He went to Eli. It was 3 times Eli said he'd call you. But at the 3rd time, Eli said, when you hear the voice again, says, speak, Lord. My servant hear it. When Samuel said that, Eli, hallelujah, did not know what was happening because he didn't hear the voice of God. His eyes of God dim. He was getting old. But God was raising up Samuel to take over. Hallelujah, to be the leader, to be king, to be leader, and church. Hallelujah, Israel. God spoke to Samuel. Somebody praise God. And I love the short of it. Is that Samuel grew up to be one of the great children of Israel. One of the great prophets and patriarchs. One of the great leaders. Amen. The word of God. In history, somebody praise God, and we give God thanks only because, hallelujah, and I prayed, and mother prayed, and God heard, and answered the prayer, and she knew that it was because of God that this man, the child of comfort, so she led him to the Lord, and God made him to be, who he wants him to be. Talk to me, somebody. Let me speak of that second. Mother, wonderful, interesting Christian mother. Amen. Let me tell you about her. This preacher preaching to you right now. God, and this mother's day. My mother told me a story when I grew up. Oh, hallelujah. And I never forget this all my life. My mother told me, Oh, yes, your father, my father was married for 5 years, but could not, amen, conceive and bring forth a child. Oh, yes, there were Christians. My father was a deacon in the church. My mother was an auxiliary leader and a prayer warrior. But all they tried, they prayed before, nothing happened. They went to the doctor, even the doctor said there was nothing wrong. Why she could not have a child, but it just would not happen. People recommended a lot of things, hallelujah, to take, but nothing happened. And of course, my mother really wanted to have a child. Oh, hallelujah. She got a bit discouraged and wondered what was happening. Was my marriage, hallelujah, not the will of God? But then God visited my father, Deacon Wilson, one night and said, "Son, I want you to know you've been praying. I know your wife has been praying. But let me tell you now, go in prayer, take your wife, Gladys Wilson, and go into 3 days and 3 nights of fasting and prayer. No food, no water. Then after that, you will see what I am going to do." My mother told me, she said, "Son, we went to church that Sunday, came home Sunday night, and we decided we are going to go into fasting. I'll start fasting on Monday." So then Monday, my wife, my mother rather, hallelujah, and my father start fasting Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, no food, no water, then locked away in the room, travailing in prayer, crying to God, reading the word, seeking God in obedience to the dream that God told my father, hallelujah, to break the fasting on Thursday morning. Oh, hallelujah. Got up Thursday morning, go home their chores, hallelujah, stop doing the chores around, went to the field and back. Thursday night, they slept because coming out of this class, they were tired and weary. Oh, glory to God. They went through Friday the following day. Hallelujah. Rejoicing and thanking God for what He is about to do. Friday night, they went together. And I said, "Kena, new Hannah. I am going to put it that way. That's not all my mother gave it to me." She said, "We get together on Friday night." But the Bible said, "They came a new honor." So Friday night, they come together. Somebody praise God. Hallelujah. And that was it. Hallelujah. A couple months after, Mother Wilson began to feel away. Hallelujah. When she checked her doctor, the doctor told her, "Mrs. Wilson, you're expecting a child." Oh, hallelujah. And of course, Mother Wilson said to me, "I have asked the Lord, since it's my first child, I asked the Lord to give me a boy child." Somebody praise the Lord. And God heard the prayer. Hallelujah. I know how much time. So I just give you in a nutshell. So that my mother said to me, "Son, guess what? Hallelujah. 9 months after, I give birth to a boy child. And that boy child is you." Hallelujah. It's amazing what prayer can do. Can you say amen? A wonderful, interesting example of what a good mother should be. Mother Eugenia Wilson, God bless her soul. She's gone on to be with the Lord now. But she prayed, and God gave her a boy child. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. After 5 years of marriage, she could not have a child. Oh, hallelujah. And that's how I come forth into this world. Somebody praise the Lord. This is what happens, bless God. Amen. That God shall to bless the family. And praise God, my mother, amen, shall to England. Hallelujah. For a while. And then, bless God, amen, after traveling to England, she decided, well, amen, I'm just going to stay for a time and come now. That's the agreement with my father herself. Can somebody praise the Lord? But she was so interested in her, amen, child. Of course, she had two children after. Amen. Two girls after me. An only boy. Hallelujah. Amen. And then come the children. Somebody bless the Lord. Hallelujah. So while there in England, praise God. Hallelujah. Even I wasn't saved. I went to school, came out of school. My mother, amen, that sent me from the country, hallelujah, to live in Kingston in front of my auntie, that I could get a trade or a skill. Hallelujah. So I went to Kingston, start learning a trade. I left that one, start learning another trade. But amen, my heart and my mind was at my mother in England. For 9 years I did not see my mother. So she decided I'm going to send for my son to come with, spend some time with me from not get ready to come back home. But she was working to support the family, but my father was just a poor farmer. Can somebody praise the Lord? Amen. So my mother paid the fare. I was 18 years of age at the time. Paid the fare, booked my fare with Christianity. Hallelujah. For me to come to England, I sailed out in a boat called the Iguana from Victoria Pier. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. One Tuesday evening to go to England. God. I sailed for 17 days and night on the Iguana boat. It was a banana boat, but it carried passengers too. And when I went to England, came to Southampton Port in England, I was so glad that finally I come to England. I've got a desire. When I was going, I said I don't want to be that trade that I was learning in Jamaica. I want to be an electrical engineer. So I decided when I go to England, I'm going to go to school and study electrical engineering. But God have another plan. Oh, you're hearing me. I said, oh, I have another plan. Praise the Lord. Guess what? Because I reached 18, there was a law in England at this time. The parents want to send for their children, amen, at 18 years old, to spend a vacation. You got to get a work permit. Yes. Praise God. My mother didn't know this. And guess what? Amen. They decided they're not landing me. So I did not land. Amen. At Southampton. My mother had sent for my mother. She came on the boat. They investigated to interrogate her. But she couldn't just convince them that I'm not going to come to stay. Hallelujah. I'm going to spend a couple of weeks with her. She said, 9 years. I haven't seen my son. It's my only son. Hallelujah. And I want you to spend a little time with me. Amen. I said, no, Mrs. Wilson. Amen. Do you work? She said, yes. Hallelujah. So when you're gone to work in the days, we want you to have to be the young man. Will you just stay at home? Amen. And praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. By himself all day, take him home from work. That will not be fear of coming into this country. Hallelujah. Amen. Just sit at home, be alone. Like that. Mother Wilson said to the immigration officers, hallelujah, she sat there. She said, well, I've got a nephew live up the road from me, and he has a little shop, and so he don't work out, he stays in the shop. So while I am gone to work, I'm just letting my son go and stay with my nephew in the days until I come back. Hallelujah, the man said, oh, okay, Mrs. Wilson, No one will get it. Your son is coming to work. We will not land him. He has to go back home to Jamaica and get a work permit. My mother passed out. Oh, she cried, but they would not listen. They had made the ruling. My mother came off the ship and went to land. Amen. Praise God. And called the British, the Jamaican consulate. And soon, very quickly, the consulate leader from the came down from the Jamaican High Commission, came down there, talked with the immigration officers. Hallelujah. And then the woman even said to them, listen, I will say, take responsibility that when the time is up, given some time, let I with this mother, when the time is up, I'll see if we can go back to Jamaica. And they said, no, he has to go back home. And guess what? I cried. My hope was dashed. I can't get to see my loved ones again. Hallelujah. My desire, ambitiously, to study electrical engineering was dashed. I went to the cabin and I cried and cried until the evening when the boat was ready to come off, was ready to sail back to Jamaica. I came out on the Haman deck, look up, I could see my mother waving. I waved back and I started to cry. And I said, guess what, you know? I remember when I was leaving Jamaica, I told my friends, I'm not to England now in Kingston. You know, I'm little, you know, sure. Hallelujah. And I'm going to go back. They know to them see me come back. I said, no, I'm not going back. And guess what? I decided to step up on the rail of the boat and jump off in the sea. I could not swim, but I decided I'm not going back. But just as I'm going to step up to jump over, I felt somebody grab me in my back. When I looked around, it was a lady. Hallelujah. She grabbed me in my back and said, son, don't do it. God knows why. Come down, come son, come, come. And she held me strongly in the back of my, even my shirt. I cried. She said, come son, come, it's not worth it. And I stepped back to her, and she said, I'm from Guyana. I lived in England all these years. I'm going back to Jamaica with my children. Good, I'm going back to Guyana rather. But I'm a Christian. Oh, hallelujah. And I realize what you are going through, but it's not worth listening. And God, the woman said, son, you may not see it now, but God had a plan for your life. Oh, Jesus. And later on, you're going to see what God is going to do to your life, and you're going to remember me. Come, son. She took me to her cabin. And she prayed for me. She prayed with me. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, somebody. I went out to sleep, sighed and cried. But she prayed with me and encouraged me, comforted me. Hallelujah. And long and short as it is, I sailed back to Jamaica. Never seen that woman again before she came off of the port to go back to Guyana. Oh, hallelujah. Then, amen, I came back. And went home the evening, went up to Kingston. I was staying at the time in my aunt. Amen. Kingston 11. Never forget. Hallelujah. 100 Pedal Road. That's where I was living at the time. And glory to God. When I went up, everybody was surprised that I had to come back home. I was so disappointed, discouraged, cast down. Oh Lord, I went back. I stayed in our meeting. Oh, hallelujah. Then after a while, hallelujah, I rose up and I wrote my mother a letter because I had read and I had heard, amen, that the Bible said the sins of the father and mother visit the third and fourth generation. I didn't know where I'd come in, but I was ignorant of the word. Oh, hallelujah. So I wrote my mother a letter, said, mommy, what it is that I am, you have done, or my father done, why I'm suffering like this. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Because my mother tried again to get me to Canada. I don't have time to share that with you. And I flew to Canada to be in there. Amen. To stay with a cousin of mine and to get a permit over there. And they turned me back to from Canada. I have a cousin that came to me afterward and said, Patrick, I heard what happened to you. I'm in America, I can't get a visa for you. Give me £40 at the time. And I gave it somehow. I worked on my mother. Amen. Sent a little bit and I gave it to him. Hallelujah. And from that day, I don't see him again until this day. 40 years, then 50 years, I don't see my cousin. So that's what brought me to the place where I said, Mother, what it is that you have done and my father has done? Why all this thing is happening to me? My mother wrote back to me and said, Son, it's not what your father has done. I read your letter with tears coming in my eyes, but it's not what your father has done. It's not what I have done, but it's not what you have done, but it's what you haven't done. You haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. I've been telling you all this while, and listen to me, son, remember your miracle child. Any day that you accept Christ as your personal Savior, things are going to get better. You won't regret it. And if you don't work, give it back to me. Oh, hallelujah. At the end of the letter, she says, son, read Psalm 27. She had given me a Bible for my birthday 2 years ago, and I never read the Bible. Just ruin it. I searched for the Bible and searched for Psalm 27, and I start to read. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Where the wicked, even my head is my foes, come upon me, the heat of my flesh, let's come and fail. The Lord set camp against me, my heart shall not fear, the Lord shall rise up against me, in this will I be confident. Hallelujah, but one thing, have I desired of the Lord, that I see after. In the house of the Lord, all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, to incline his temple, for the time of trouble, he shall hide me. I read right down to where he said, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way. I went down to the last verse. It said, wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he shall spread the heart. Well, thanks to the Lord. And guess what? Tears start to roll down. Tears start to roll down. My eyes, I fell on the floor in the room and cried. I cried. I weeped before the Lord all night on the floor in my room, and I prayed. I said, God, if you help me and get me out of this, I promise you, Lord, I will serve you for the rest of my life. And God, I'm not gonna turn back. If you see, I'm gonna turn back. Take me, Lord, out of the world. God, but I'm gonna serve you and do what you want me to do for the rest of my life. Oh, hallelujah. When I slept on the floor at the day at the morning, oh, can you say amen? I got up, that was Saturday, it was Saturday morning. And normally, I would go out with my friends, even to play dominoes and do some foolish things on the racehorse. Hallelujah. But I got a shirt, I went and got a shirt, and decided I'm going to church. I took up my birthday Bible and walked down from church, down to Pendle Road, at the bottom of Pendle Road, a church of God church was there. Oh, hallelujah. It was early. Hallelujah. I went, and the deacon opened the door. I went inside and sat there until church started.
distracted when the pastor preach. I'm just rushing in because time is against me. But I want you to come through that you get. This is my testimony. A wonderful mother who prayed and submitted to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I prayed. I went to the church and the pastor preached. I can't tell you the message he preached. But when he was through, I said, is there one that will give your heart to Jesus today? I jumped to my feet, went and knelt at the altar. The pastor came. Some prayer mothers and warriors came. They laid hands on me. I cried before God and God. I said, God, I surrender all to you. Oh, to Jesus. Roshana, I surrender all to him. I freely give. I always love and trust you. In your presence, I daily live. They pray for me. They pray the dead out of me. And Jesus came and built me. I surrender my life to Jesus. That Sunday morning, at the Church of God, down the bottom of Pendle Road. I'm not sure if it's 15 Pendle Road or 45. Hallelujah. Praise God. I gave my heart to Jesus. And I promised God. And from that day until now, oh glory to God, I've never looked back. I've been baptized. I surrender to God. God fill me with the Holy Ghost. Can you say amen? I said, God fill me with the Holy Ghost. I started to sing in choir in the church. That is a different church now. I want the Bible. I just got to amen, conclude amen this, because there's more to it, but I'm just putting it in a nutshell. Hallelujah. I didn't stay at that church. I went to another church. Hallelujah. But this was for a special reason. And one day, I was in the choir singing one Sunday morning, and the pastor came out to preach. He turned around and looked at me in the choir among dozens of young men and young women. He said, young man, son, come down here. I want to pray for you. The Lord showed you to me in a vision last night, and I've got to pray for you. I said, me, sir. He said, yes. And the man of God, hallelujah, praise God, lay hands on me. He said, son, guess what? The Lord appeared to me and told me to tell you that you are born from your mother's womb to preach the gospel. I warn to you, if you preach not this gospel, he anointed me with oil and prayed for me. I fell out on the floor. Oh, God, I didn't get up until the service was over. And guess what? From that day, hallelujah, it's going to be 50 years now. Here, just 2 years, I did it to be 50 years ago. And I get up and say, God, I'll go where you want me to go. I'll be what you want me to be. I'll say what you want me to say. I went to a little Bible school, graduated from Bible school. Hallelujah, and start preaching. The same bishop, man of God, called you on Sunday morning. Hundreds of people was in the church and said, the Lord appeared to me, young man, last night and tell me you should bring the message. I said, what, sir? He said, yes, young man. I went around the back to the prayer room and I cried to God. I said, God, I never preach yet. I gave him a sermon at his Bible school, but I can't preach a sermon to so much people. And on Sunday morning, the Lord said, yes, son. I said, what should I preach? The Lord said to me, the mysterious change. The mysterious change. Oh, God Almighty. And I looked back up. Hallelujah. God changed my life mysteriously. And there's a mysterious change to come. That mysterious change is found in 1 Corinthians 15, where God said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall all be changed. I came out and started preaching that word. That church was on its feet. Everybody on its feet. People run to the altar and start crying. Dozens of people got saved that day. And from that day on, here I am today. preaching the word. My mama, God is old Jean Wilson. She's gone to be with the Lord now. At 85, she went with to the Lord. But God Almighty, hallelujah, her mother, amen, brought me to this world after prayer and fasting. Her mother witnessed to me, and I surrender my life to Jesus. Come you say amen. I gave myself to God, and here I am today, preaching the word for 40 years, non-stop. The same England that they turned me away from the first time, hallelujah, praise God, I decided I want to go to England now to visit with my mother. I went to the embassy. Can you say amen? Praise God out here, hallelujah. No, it wasn't the embassy time yet. Hallelujah. At that time, as a commonwealth citizen, you can travel to England. I put my fear. Hallelujah. My fear. And we traveled to England. Hallelujah. When I went to the airport, all they asked me, how long do you want to stay? Oh, God. And I said, I want to stay 2 weeks. They gave me 6 months. Now, today, I can tell you, I have been to England, amen, 30 times already. And they never asked me what I'm coming for. And I'm never coming to stay. But the Lord tell me, surely you shall travel to and fro the world, preaching the gospel. For your base, your home base, is in Jamaica. Oh, hallelujah. I traveled to Canada. When I went to Canada, all they asked me, how long do you want to stay? I said, 2 weeks. Hallelujah, they gave me 6 months. Lord God, hallelujah, I've been to Canada so many times. When I went to America, the embassy, they asked me, how long are you going to stay? I said, 2 weeks. They gave me 6 months. And I can't remember the amount of time I have been to America. I traveled overseas. I've traveled in nearly 30 countries of the world, preaching the gospel. Oh, hallelujah. I've been to France. I've been under the Eiffel Tower. At Paris, come on. I go preach the word of God. Are you hearing me, somebody? And here I am today because of mother, a wonderful mother, an interesting mother, an example mother. Hallelujah. Amen of what is good. Hallelujah. What, amen, a mother should be. Amen. She caused me to stand before you right now. Thousands of souls. Thousands of souls have been won to the Lord. I preached in so many revivals throughout England and Wales. Are you hearing me, somebody? Throughout many states in America, many parts of the West Indies and Canada, I've been here preaching the word of God because of my mother. My mother brought me to the Lord. My mother witnessed to me. My mother prayed and fought for me to be here. And here I am today. Oh, hallelujah. I've been through many things, but I'm still here. Can you say amen? I've been through many trials. Hallelujah, but I'm still here. God made something beautiful of my life. Hallelujah, somebody. I must close it. Oh, glory to God. Proverbs 31, verse 1. Hallelujah. The Bible said, even the words of King Lemuel, the prophecy that his mother taught him. Hallelujah. His mother taught him what, son? And she taught him about the things of God. I don't have time to share them with you, but she taught. I will come on next time. But she taught him the things of God. And I believe God blessed him. And we come down to verse 10 of Proverbs 31. And this is for you, mothers. Oh, some of you are not saved yet, but give your heart to the Lord. Oh, some of you have not yet given and led your child to the Lord. You complain and quarreling. The boy is bad. The girl is bad. What am I going to do with them? I don't know what to do with my child. Oh, God, I give him trouble. But I want to go in fasting and prayer like Hannah. Oh, hallelujah. Like Emmanuel's mother. Like Mother Wilson and many others. Oh, hallelujah. I want to pray to God. And God will do something in their life. God will change your life. Guess what? Verse 10 of Proverbs 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doing safely, trust in her. Yes, your husband must trust safely in you. Hallelujah. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Thank God for the wife that God blessed me with. We are married non-stop now. Bless the Lord. February, God, we just celebrated 46 years of marriage. Out of our shadow. 46 years of marriage to one child, one young lady. One lady the Lord gave me. I passed that prayer and asked God to give me her. Christian lady. Hallelujah. We stay and God give me a wife. Hallelujah. We are celebrating the 46 years of marriage. God has blessed me with 4 children. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. My eldest son is a, amen, a pastor, man of God. Amen. Hallelujah. In the Cayman Islands right now, preaching the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. The heart of her husband. Amen. Do it safely. Trust in her. Husband must trust safely in your wife. Hello? I can trust my wife. My wife don't search my wallet. My wife don't search my phone. She trusts me. My wife don't search the drawer. I don't search nothing for her. And she don't search nothing for me. Can you say amen? Because she know I'm not hiding anything for her. Amen, somebody. All I'm hiding for her. Amen. She know already. And there's love in my heart for her. That's what is in my heart. And she know me in her heart. Hallelujah. Somebody praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. God bless me. Hallelujah. And we give God glory. Amen. My second daughter is in Canada. Amen. Graduate of university with her bachelor's of science and her master's degree. Hallelujah. 2 different universities. One in the States and one in Canada. Serving the Lord now. We don't have time to tell her, but God is good. And other children are blessed of God doing their own business and working to God in the glory. Can we say amen? Hallelujah. Verse 12 of Proverbs 31. She will do it good and not evil all the day of her life. My wife, Valerie, will do me good. Believe that. All the days of her life. All the days of my life. The way she treat me now. The way she treat me. I know that she will do me good for the rest of my life. Oh, Jesus. And I will do her good for the rest of her life. Tell somebody, praise the Lord. Wonderful mother. Many daughters have done virtuously, verse 29. Hallelujah. But now excel them all. Favor and deceive. Amen. And beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. I close with that. A woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Oh, hallelujah. Love and respect to all your mothers out here. But a woman, mother, that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Now guess what? She learned to praise the Lord. She learned to pray when things seem hopeless. When things are not going well, she will resort to prayer and fasting, and God will work for her. Can you say amen? God bless you. Happy Mother's Day. I rejoice. My mother is at the portals of glory now. Looking down, listen to me. Someday I will join her in glory, also my father. Thank God for this Mother's Day. I remember mother. I remember mama. Oh, oh, she did a son. I said, I remember mama in a happy way. I wonder how many of you can say that right now. Shamu suffering time. I wonder how many of your children can say, I remember mama in a happy way. Oh God, I remember. I wonder how many of your mamas, your child can sing to you. I remember my mama in a happy way. I remember my mama in a happy way. That's why I feel led to share this with you today. And if you're listening to me right now and know me, you'll never hear my testimony yet. But I share the testimony in a nutshell. But this is how it happened. And here I am today. Somebody pray for Lord. God bless you, let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your word. Thank you for the testimony. Thank you, God, for your word. What on your shoulders and your countless other mothers in this Bible. That God will pray and you will answer their prayer. And there are countless mothers, God, apart from me, that they have prayed. And God, you have done something in the family, in their child life, you have given them a miracle. And there are those that are praying right now, and waiting on God for a miracle. There are those that are going through this difficult challenge as we face COVID, COVID-19, and the coronavirus pestilence. It's creating havoc in the land, in the ocean. But mama is praying in the name of Jesus. Pray, word is praying. I pray God will hear and answer the prayer of the children. In Jesus' name, keep the family, God. Keep the families. And I pray for all the mothers all over the world that's listening, in the churches and outside, God. I pray for the mothers. Bless them on this Mother's Day. Encourage their heart and strengthen them. And God, may something that has been said reach their hearts. Divine God, that they will turn to you and resort to prayer and fasting. Resort to the Word of God. That Lord Jesus, their children, their loved ones, they themselves will turn to God. And God will make something beautiful of their life. Touch her, God, I pray for you on this Mother's Day. Open up, God, I pray for you. Bless you, Mother. And those mothers who are praying, oh, hallelujah, for a child, you'll answer their prayer. Those who are saying, God, look for me, they'll give themselves to prayer and fasting. Like Anna did. Like this mother did in Proverbs. Like my mother did. And God will hear and answer prayer. Bless your children everywhere. Give mercy and grace. Provide for your children. Those mothers that with children, Lord, and God, no support. Single mothers, Lord. Father, God, let them. God, I pray you meet their needs. Stand by them. Open doors. May the real bless. Jesus, we thank you. Move to the nations right now. Oh, God Almighty. When this amen of the Sea of Galilee. When the ship was going through the storm, the disciples had prayed. God, and nothing happened. The cast on the top things of the cargo, nothing happened. But they went to you downstairs. You slept through the storm when you came up and said, peace be still. Jesus, in your own time, I pray that you'll speak to the coronavirus pestilence and say, peace be still. And I know it shall cease. I thank you. You speak to me earlier on and said, this too will pass. And I thank you, Lord. Speak to it, Lord. Speak to those in quarantine. Speak to those in hospital. Speak to those, Lord. Minister to them. God, and heal and raise them up, Lord. And restore life. But more than all, those who are not saved will turn their life over to you and start serving God while they have a chance before it's too late. In Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all my fears. Because I know, yes, I know he holds the future. My life is worth while living just because he lives. It is no secret what God can do, but he has done for others, he will do it for you. We need his hands wide open. He pardoned me, he will pardon you. It is no secret. I speak healing, I speak deliverance, I speak blessing, I speak a change upon your life. Right now in Jesus' name, we bind you, the blood is against you. Take your hands up on that mother life, that your lady's life, that woman's life. I rebuke you, heaven, take your hands up of her life. And I speak success and prosperity. I speak fertility, shells of your power, and success. Yeah.